You started the campaign, the opposition alliance started about a year and a half ago, the India Out campaign. Now that you know that was a main one of the main topics, campaign topics in the during the run up to the election. Now that you have won the election, now you are assuming power now. So what happens to this India Out campaign?
Well, it doesn't. I mean, India out is not what we are. I mean, it because we have foreign military troops here. It happens to be from India. The point is, we don't want any foreign military boots to be in the Maldivian soil. That's it. The people of the Maldives don't want any foreign military presence to be in our country, and right now it happens to be Indian military presence here. And that's exactly what we are trying to address, what the people of the Maldives want to be addressed. And that's what the people voted me in for. And I promised to them, and I'm going to live up to my promise from day one. And in fact, I have even met with the Indian High Commissioner during this transition period, and it was a very cordial, friendly meeting. And he acknowledged the real need of our people, that the request of our people is what should be, genuinely looked into. And I really hope, and I'm very confident that the Indian government and we can sit together, talk together, and easily solve this issue, because it's the right of any country to have their sovereignty being quite clearly, without any foreign influences as such. We don't want any foreign military presence in our soils. That's all. And I'm sure with proper dialogue, for proper diplomacy, we can solve this issue. And it's just putting our nations in interest at first. At first, what my policy is, it's for the Maldives' interest to be put first. And I'm sure with that, every country will respect it. And it's the right of every country to have their independence and sovereignty being, quite certainly, accepted by the international community.
The reason why these Indian military personnel they are there in the Maldives, according to India, is to maintain two helicopters donated by India and also one smaller Dornier aircraft, which according to them it is basically for maritime work and for rescue. What will happen to those the helicopters and the aircraft? Because the very basis for this dozens of people staying there is to maintain and operate these aircraft.
Well, we have quite a lot of trained, even our military staff, from MNDF, Maldives National Defense Force. We have a lot of trained soldiers who can run and operate these all these helicopters and Dornier aircraft and so on. And we have a plan, and I put that during the campaign. That we will invest in bringing an air ambulance, at least one or two air ambulances, properly equipped to be, operated in the Maldives with all the specialist personnel. It's going to be civilian. And I think we don't need military troop, I mean, personnel from military soldiers to be here to run this.
Will you ask them
Helicopters.
to take back as it was done during the administration of President Abdullah Yameen a few years ago?
I don't think the helicopters or the Dornier aircraft need to be removed. I think it can be easily solved. They just need to be replaced with some civilian pilots and operators. I think the Indian government will address that, and I think they will exchange with civilians.
Whereas the critics would say, some of the critics in Maldives and outside, they say that you are a pro-China person who wants more relations with China, and that's why one of the reasons why you do not want India to have a foothold. How do you see this kind of criticism?
See, I'm a pro-Maldives person. For me, Maldives comes first. Our independence comes first. Our sovereignty comes first. Any country that's respecting that, I'm sure all the countries will respect that, will be our friends. And India is our close neighbor. it's not going to change. It's not going to change ever. So that's it. And China or other countries are, just same force when it comes to the question of sovereignty and independence. I'm not against or pro any country.
Would you
So
allow
that's
China to establish any presence in the Maldives?
I will not allow any country to establish any military presence in our country.